Hello everyone, and now welcome to game number 2 in the series here on Turtle Rock. Focus versus Moon, as we see Focus spawning as the yellow orc here at the 11 o'clock position. Am I talking a little bit differently? Yes, I am. I'm not quite sure why, but I guess a lot of people listen to my cast while trying to sleep, so rather than trying to get the all high energy cast that I sometimes do, I'll mix it up a little bit and I guess use my smooth jazz talk, even though I don't know quite what to say. Anyways, we are going at 2x speed right now until we get to that 2-minute mark. Demon Hunter will be making its rounds out as we see an Ancient of War being built very, very far away from home, but very close to this 3322 creep camp. Meanwhile, we can see a Blade Master is being added, and Focus is once again using a similar strategy that we saw in game number 1. Looks as though the Archer has already started that damage, as well as we now go to 1x speed. Archer is going to go ahead and easily finish off one of those Ogre Warriors. Now, only going to be a matter of time before the Demon Hunter shows up to the party and is able to finish everything else off. Alright, Forest Troll number 1 has been taken down. Ogre Warrior number 2 about to get taken down as the Ancient of War makes his slow end walk all the way to this sea turtle, giant sea turtle creep camp. Blade Master off to the north over here, hoping to finish off an Ogre Magi. Should be able to do exactly that. Only a circuit of nobility, no healing salves as of yet, but we do see him pick up a pendant of energy. Pendant of energy, an additional 150 mana, very, very large amount of mana indeed, as that should be given to the Tauren Chieftain later on in order to try and get additional shockwaves. Demon Hunter now making its rounds, finishing off another 322 creep camp as we see Moon has decided the tech for, well, he decided the tech, evasion first on that Demon Hunter as opposed to mana burn. Most likely he does have mana burn right now, unless he is going for some crazy mana burn immolation strategy. I would not highly recommend it, but if anyone could pull it off, it would be definitely Moon. Alright, Ancient of War back across over here, already in position. The timing was just right, just perfect for the Demon Hunter to try and get all of those items there. You do see Slippers of Agility plus 3 now added. Claws of Attack plus 6 added, as well as we'll see what that follow-up play will be. Meanwhile, back across over here, Blade Master looking to finish off another Ogre Magi, perhaps pick up a very, very powerful item again. There it goes, picks up a Ring of Protection plus 3. Gonna go ahead and quickly sell that, and instead add a Circlet of Nobility, which gives 50 additional hit points and 50 additional hit points and plus 2 attack and 0.6 armor. Already up to 1.2 at this stage in the game, as the Demon Hunter looks to head off to the north here and finish off another giant sea turtle creep camp. Is the Demon Hunter gonna finish it off? Yes, without a problem. Once more, the Grunt was hoping for the steal, but does not get the last hit this time. Blade Master still wandering around. Demon Hunter looking, selling the unnecessary items, and now picks up a Staff of Teleportation, Ring of Protection plus 2, Slippers of Agility plus 3, Claws of Attack plus 6. By themselves, not that powerful, but when their powers combine, well, harder hitting, take less damage, well, I guess that's pretty much it. Attack slightly faster hero is going to be on the board. Demon Hunter now making its rounds off to the north. Is it going to try and finish off these units? No, it is not. We do see a Tauren Chieftain now being added here as the Beastmaster, looking to clear out some easy, easy creep camps. Beastmaster looks like he is ready to get down into business, looking to finish off the remainder of these. Well, this 3-3-2-2 creep camp. Ogre Warriors are still here. And is the Beastmaster going to try and engage? Yes, he is going to go ahead and try and engage against this Ogre Warrior. Meanwhile, what will be happening next? Units are now looking all to back off, trying to share all of that aggro. We're seeing exactly that. The Quill Beast able to still deal 13 to 15 damage, as all of the other units are, well, all of the other units are starting to get into that pelt in action. Blade Master is still sitting at level 2. Tauren Chieftain is finally out on the board, but without any experience. as the Blade Master is looking to see where exactly Moon is. Moon has not done anything terribly tricky or terribly risky so far. He's just playing a very clean game, and that sometimes clean games wins you championships, or at least series, as the Forest Troll Warlord will get taken down now. Ogre Warriors, Forest Troll Berserkers now getting cleaned up. Belt of Giant Strength plus 6, an additional 150 hit points and faster regeneration. Looking to finish off the last of the Forest Troll Berserkers, as well as the Blade Master does mosey on in. Dust of Appearance, is he going to be able to get a mana burn off? There is some big damage. Archer down to 81 hit points. Wants to get away, but instead just going to be walking straight into a grunt. Blade Master, Quill Beast looking to, is it going to run away? No, it's simply just going to allow the Forest Troll Berserker to finish him off as he disappears back home. Ancient of War here, ready to go. Meanwhile, Demon Hunter, Beastmaster here, ready to go as well. Demon Hunter sitting at 2, Beastmaster sitting at 2. If we can get these to level 3, that would be a tremendous difference, as the Ancient of War is still just standing off in the shadows. Gargantuan Sea Turtles, currently all that is left, with some giant sea turtles in the center portion of the map, as the Blade Master now clears out an Ogre Merchant a creep shop, which is currently down its Ogre Warrior. Beastmaster, Druids of the Talon now here, ready to go. Raiders are going to be coming across. Are they going to try and engage? That is the big question. Ancient of War taking a lot of damage so far with really nothing to show for it. Raider, does he spot this? I'm not 100% sure. I'm not quite sure if he... No, yeah, I believe he does, in fact, spot it there, even though it is on high ground. The use of the units to try and pull those units back and forth, still not quite working with those Quill Beasts. Forces are under attack. Tauren Chieftain sitting at level 2. Spirit Walker is taking a bit more damage. Giant Sea Turtle taking a little bit of damage as well. Looks like it is going to get ticked off or taken out. I'm getting in some extra shots once again. Blade Master now taking in those extra shots again. As you see, that damage is keeping him at about half health. Gargantuan Sea Turtle about to get finished off. Demon Hunter now sitting at 3. Beastmaster still sitting comfortably at 2. Gets stabbed a preservation home, so that all of the experience will go to the Beastmaster. Very smart play here, as the Beastmaster does get to level 3 ever so barely. And now with 2 level 3 heroes, he does stand to fight against this, well, 2-3-2 hero combination as well. Tauren Chieftain, however, will get to level 3, and it is going to come down to positioning and who can finish off the remainder of these units and set themselves up for the endgame. Wand of Mana Stealing, very, very powerful indeed. Meanwhile, we are heading out across the ramp. Quill Beast trying to engage. Beastmaster is right there. Are we going to perhaps see any units trying to transition away? Yes, there is one Raider right there looking to transition. Could get an ensnare off. There it goes. Hawk, as the Moon is now taking some serious damage. All right, down to 64 or 6 hit points. There it goes. Quickly taken out. Blade Master also finishing up the Clockwork Factory, as the Blade Master now mana burns down that one Tauren Chieftain. All right, Blade Master ready to go to get taken out. There it goes. There's the Cyclone finishing off the Goblin Tinker. Goblin Tinker unable to dodge that, as all of those units were just far too close. And the Blade Master and the Tauren Chieftain look to be swinging this back around. Very, very high damage. All of his heroes are still alive, pretty much focused right now. If that Blade Master ever gets to level 5, things are going to be incredibly different, as we see back over here. Wait, where attack. Are we? Did we head back over here or here? Blade Master now still stuck up in the air. Beastmaster ready to go. Mana Burn onto a Spirit Walker once more. Does not have the Boots of Speed. Does end up getting ensnared, as we now see the Beastmaster going to go ahead and try and finish off a low hit point Raider, as the Blade Master, oh, Scroll of Healing used just in time, but Raider number 1 going to get taken down, or number 2 getting taken down anyways. All right, another Raider able to escape. Quill Beast continuing the fight once more. Demon Hunter looking to engage. There go some peons, as the Blade Master does get to level 4, but unable to wind walk again.
Slayer's forces
not,
are under attack.
Not quite sure why the Demon Hunter and the Tauren Chieftain are fighting against each other. That's actually a really, really big mistake. Staff of Preservation now coming across. As you see, a Shockwave does go down. All right, Focus actually shocked wave all of his units here. And we'll see what's going to be the long-term proposition as the Demon Hunter unable to finish off this Blade Master combination. All right, Beastmaster sitting at 3. Blade Master sitting at 4 now. As the Demon Hunter falls at level 3. All right, Druids of the Talon are falling left and right as the Tauren Chieftain unable to get back up and perhaps stabilize. He's going to have a lucky things go his way in order to really mount a comeback. Warcraft 3, it is very difficult to amass a very, very strong combat when you're losing three of the main categories. Blademaster going to town on a Goblin Tinker. There it goes again. How many times have we seen that happen as we're now at 49 over 60? Meanwhile, back down to the south, Goblin Tinker is still leering, bringing up the rear. There's a Cyclone onto the Blademaster. Blademaster is a bit far away from home. Does have to try and be careful as we're looking at, well, some Raiders getting finished off. Beastmaster, Blademaster, Demon Hunter, Tauren Chieftain, all of them hovering around 4 or 3 experience, except maybe the Beastmaster who's still at, no, he's at 3 as well. So everyone is pretty much ready to go. Goblin Tinker still has a long way to go as we're looking at, well, the Raiders now marching on in. They're going to try and jack this creep camp. Little did they know that it is completely and full right here. That's what they were checking out first to see if they can easily creep out this creep camp. Very difficult to creep out creep camps. Ogre Warrior down over here has been finished off. There you go. Beastmaster is going to be ready to go as well. Unholy Aura coupled with some additional auras does mean that your army is moving very, very fast. And movement is absolutely key in any type of war. Ogre Lord now taken down here. Spirit Walker should have no problem finishing it off. They do deal double damage as we see a Pipe of Insight and also Brilliance Aura given to that Tauren Chieftain. Coming back across over here. Fairy Dragons are going to be slowly added back up as well. We're at 50 over 50. Are we going to start seeing some sacrificial units in order to set up the next play? As there is a Bat Rider here who wants to try and disrupt any sort of expansion play or even sequel play coming.
A player's forces are under attack. Yeah.
Anyways, Focus now going to be coming across 59 over 60 once more. Gargantuan Sea Turtle is quickly going to get ensnared as they are finished. Tauren Chieftain will stay at level 4. Blademaster may actually get to level 5 though. Going to be very, very close as the units are now ready to engage here. All right, are we going to see some Cyclone? There is one Cyclone, two Cyclone. The Tauren Chieftain and the Blademaster know it does not make any sense to really try and engage while those units are nearby as they're just going to be able to constantly ensnare. Raiders at about, well, one hit from full. As the Beastmaster looking to discontinue this fight again. All right, are the Wisps going to be able to get through this party and perhaps get some key detonations off on all of these units? Let's take a look at this. Shockwave now comes across. Druids of the Talon now being added as well. Are these Spirit Walkers going to actually try and go into ethereal form to hide? As the Demon Hunter and the Tauren Chieftain once again battle it out. Shockwave across multiple units there. Tauren Chieftain with plenty of mana, and that could potentially be a problem. Too much mana does cause problems there, as we now see the Blademaster and the Tauren Chieftain looking to back off. Goblin Tinker is now back in. Demon Hunter now back in on the fight as well, looking to continually fight once more, but this is just so problematic. What is this guy trying to do? Well, apparently, well, Focus is yellow. Wind Rider, or, yeah, Wolf Riders also look like orange Wolf Riders as well. Anyways, thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Hope you guys enjoyed game number 2 and Moon taking this series 2-0. Well, I believe that to be the case. All right. Wow. Focus with the higher score, but Moon actually the one with the victory. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Hope you guys enjoyed it.